Harper Children's Audio presents Big Nate on a Roll by Lincoln Peirce, performed by Fred Berman. Chapter 1. I never really noticed before how boring the detention room is. I guess that's not exactly breaking news. Any room where the main activities are 1. Sitting quietly with your head on the desk, or 2. Writing, "I will not make vulgar noises during Mary Ellen Papowski's flute performance" 100 times isn't exactly Thrillsville. By the way, I'm not here because I made vulgar noises during Mary Ellen Papowski's flute performance. That was last week. And it wasn't even on purpose.
And now, here's Mary Ellen with Flight of the Bumblebee. Belch!
What I mean is, the room itself is boring. The only things on the wall are 2 signs. One says, "Quiet, please." And the other, just in case anybody's too dense to figure out sign number 1, says, "No talking." I'm not expecting them to have a TV in here or anything, but would it kill them to put up a couple of posters? Ooh! Posters! Mrs. Chirwicky? Mrs. Chirwicky!
Huh? Oh, what is it, Nate?
See how it took her a second to answer? She's all wrapped up in one of her cheesy romance novels. Welcome to the Mrs. Chirwicky Book Club.
Wowza.
Some recent selections: Acres of Passion by O. MacDonald. Love Overboard by Sue Nami. Irregular Heartbeat by Paul Pitation. Can I zip down to the art studio for a sec? She raises an eyebrow.
The art studio? What for?
To get some supplies. I'll crank out a few posters to jazz things up in here. Down goes the eyebrow.
Nate, she says, PS38 has no interest in jazzing up the detention room.
Exactly, I answer. That's why I'm volunteering to do it.
Sit down.
Okay, so much for that idea. Guess Mrs. C's in one of her no-nonsense moods. Sometimes she's a little more chatty, but that's usually when it's just her and me. Today, there are 3 other kids in here. Name: Seth Quincy. Why he's here: he got so mad at a bunch of kids for calling him Q-Tip, he totally snapped. Personally, I think it's kind of a cool nickname, but that's just me. Name: Lee Ann Pfister. Why she's here: she broke the rule that says you can't wear shirts or blouses that show off your belly button. Not only that, she has an Audi. Name: Chester Budrick. Why he's here: he wanted to trade lunches with Eric Fleury, but Eric said no. So Chester stuffed a hot dog up Eric's nose. Did I mention Chester is kind of a psycho? And then there's me. You probably want to know how I ended up here. Well, that makes 2 of us. It wasn't my fault. Not even close. It was pretty much all Artur's doing. And of course, I got detention while Artur, a.k.a. Mr. Lucky, got absolutely nothing. It's sort of a long story. But I guess I've got plenty of time, so I'll go ahead and tell it. Nate's Real Life Comics, starring me. Real drama, real action. It all started yesterday after school, when Mr. Rosa said,
"Ah, Nate, you're just the kid I'm looking for."
"I am?"
"I'm rounding up students to paint scenery for the school play. Can you help?"
"Sure."
"Follow me."
Obviously, Mr. Rosa chose me for my amazing art skills. But wait, not so fast.
"This part of the project is a 2-man job."
"A 2-man job? You and me?"
"No, I mean you and Artur." Pet, pet.
Ominous music!
"Artur, since you are so wonderful, I'm going to let you paint the mountains and clouds."
Okay. Thanks, you're very good.
Artur's charming broken English. Nate, you...
Yes?
Yes? We'll hold the ladder for Artur.
What?
Okay, Nate. I am to climbing up now.
Oh, don't you just love his cute accent?
He's so dreamy. Brush, brush.
This stinks.
Drip, drip.
Hey, watch it, Artur. You're dripping on me.
Suddenly,
bloop.
Gah! I can't see. Stagger, stumble.
Yoop! Bump, crash,
wham!
Good heavens! Artur, are you all right?
Is Artur all right?
Nate, you were supposed to be holding the ladder.
I was, but
Artur could have been badly hurt falling from such a height. Perhaps a detention will teach you a lesson.
I already know the lesson. Artur always wins. The end.
It's true. He does always win.
Let's face it. Artur has everything going for him. He's friendly. He's smart. He's good at practically everything. All the teachers love him, and so do the kids. Hey, even I like him, and I can't stand the guy. He's just so annoying. Want to know what else is annoying? Because I got detention, which, just so we're clear on this, was thanks to Artur. I'm going to be late for my Timber Scout meeting. Yep, I'm a scout. I used to want nothing to do with scouting, because every time Francis and Teddy came back from a Timber Scout camping trip, they always had food poisoning. Or worse.
Whoop! Do I look like I knew it was a hornet's nest?
But they finally convinced me to give it a try. It's not as dorky as I thought it might be. There are a few lame parts, but those are balanced out by the good stuff. Like the uniform. The uniform rocks! Beret. Clip-on neckerchief. Name stitched on shirt. Timber Scout insignia. Merit badges. Sporty stripe. Even the beret is kind of cool. I have to admit, before I joined the Timber Scouts, I thought the only people who wore berets were French guys and mimes.
Anyone for a baguette?
Le Wolf?
He's in an imaginary box!
Get an imaginary life. Anyway, the stinking meeting's already started. Maybe I can make the second half of it. Maybe, if Mrs. Chirwicky ever let us out of here. Look at your watch. Look at your watch.
Look at your watch.
Oops. Time's up. You may leave now, people.
Yes!
I explode out of my chair, race down the hallway to my locker, grab my uniform, and duck into the bathroom to change. 30 seconds later, and Teddy's house, here I come. Teddy's dad is our troop leader, so our meetings are always at his place. It's a 15-minute walk from here. But on my skateboard, I'll make it in 5. I strap on my helmet and push off. I zip along Haywood Avenue, turn left onto Pepper Street, and start across the bridge over Beard's Creek, which really isn't a creek. It's more like a combination swamp and garbage dump.
Zoom!
Whoop! Coming through! There's a woman walking her dog up ahead. Well, maybe dog isn't the right word. It's one of those toy poodles that looks like somebody glued cotton balls to a weasel. I mean, if you're gonna have a dog like that, why not just get a cat? The woman moves to her left when she hears me coming, but the dog goes the other way. Before I can slow down, her leash is stretched across the sidewalk like a tripwire, and I'm heading straight into it.
Oh, no!
Yip! Ack! Wham! I sort of flip while I'm falling, so I end up landing on my backpack. That's the good news. The bad news is, my skateboard keeps going. It shoots under the bridge railing, dive bombs into the creek, sploosh, and sinks into the oily water. Goodbye, skateboard. The dog's yapping, the woman's babbling, and people are rubbernecking as they drive by. But I can't focus on any of it. I think maybe I'm in shock.
All I can do is look down at the ripples in the water where my boar disappeared forever. Are you all right? Young man, are you okay? Thank goodness you were wearing that helmet.
Yip, 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 yip.
I take off my helmet in disgust and stuff it in my backpack. No more riding. Now I have to walk. This whole disaster is one big Artur chain reaction. If he hadn't spilled paint on me, I wouldn't have, one, bumped into the ladder, two, landed in detention, three, been late to my Timber Scout meeting, four, ridden my skateboard to Teddy's house, five, crashed into that lady and her dog, and six, lost my board in the creek. See how it all fits together? Thanks a lot, Artur. It takes a while, but I finally get to Teddy's house.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.